गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर स्टेइंग एट योर होम सेफली। सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन यस्टरडे वीडियो आई हैड डिस्कस विथ यू ऑल द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द चैप्टर इन द किंगडम ऑफ फूल्स एंड कैरेक्टर्स एज वेल एज आई हैव गिवन यू द शॉर्ट चैप्टर स्केच इन दैट वीडियो। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द चैप्टर मीन्स द पैराग्राफ वाइज। Before starting the chapter, I will be giving you a short, quick review of this chapter. So, this story is taken from A.K. Ramanujan's folk tales from India. The story is all about a kingdom of fools. As I told you, that this kingdom is of about the fools one. This kingdom is ruled by a foolish king and his foolish ministers. Once they ordered that night should be considered as a day and vice versa. That was a rule. One day, a guru and his disciple visit this kingdom and are surprised to find the entire kingdom asleep during the day. The guru immediately leaves the kingdom with his disciple as he feels danger in staying in such a kingdom. So this is the introduction which I have given you, and now I'll start with my chapter. So the first paragraph goes like this: In the kingdom of fools, both the king and ministers were idiots. They didn't want to run things like other kings, so they decided to change night into day and day into night. They ordered that everyone should be awake at night till their fields and run their business only after dark and go to bed as soon as the sun came up. Anyone who disobeyed would be punished with death. The people did as they were told for fear of death. So students, till now I have read this chapter, so I just give you a explanation that there was a kingdom of fools. In this kingdom, both the king and the minister were idiot. They reversed everything and denied justice to their people, means they changed day into night and night into day, and they ordered their people to sleep during day and work only after dark, and if anyone disobeyed this order would be put to death. So the people did accordingly because of fear. The king and the minister were delighted at the success of their project. So if the rules were followed by the was followed by the people of that kingdom, so the minister and the king was very much delighted with the success of this their project. And what was their project? That the people should work at night and sleep at morning time. So one day a guru and his disciple arrived in the city. It was a beautiful city. It was broad daylight, but there was no one about. Everyone was asleep, not a mouse stirring. Even the cattle had been taught to sleep by day. The two strangers were amazed by what they saw around them and wandered around town till evening, when suddenly the whole town woke up and went about its nightly business. So what happened? One day two men, means a guru and a disciple, visited the kingdom and found everything reverse. Means that was a beautiful kingdom, but when they arrived it was a daytime and they found everyone was there was no one. Even the cattle was also trained. Unko bhi is tarike se training di gayi thi that at night they gaze at the field, and when the morning will be there they went for a sleep. So they were surprised to see people asleep in the broad daylight and the darkness. And when the darkness spread, means when the evening was there, what they saw, that the town was full of people. Everyone became very much active and their surprise doubled. Why? Because when they see that they were doing their business in the night. So the two men were hungry. Second paragraph: the two men were hungry. Now that the shops were open, they went to buy some groceries. To their astonishment, they found that everything cost the same, a single doodoo, whether they bought a measure of rice or bunch of bananas. It caused a doo-doo. The guru and his disciple were delighted. They had never heard of anything like this. They could buy all the food they wanted for a rupee. So now what happened? Both of them, means the guru and a disciple, were very much hungry. So they wanted to eat something. So when they went to the market, and in the night they saw that they were very much surprised, because their surprise was doubled. Why? Because when they went to the market and found that everything cost the same, a single doodoo, that is a local currency of that kingdom. Doodoo means a local currency of that kingdom. So the guru and his disciple were happy because the system allowed them to buy all the food they wanted for a single doodoo. If means if they are going to buy a dozen of banana, that also cost a single doodoo, and if they are going to buy a 1 kg of rice, that also cost a one doodoo. See next third paragraph. When they had cooked and eaten, the guru realized that this was a kingdom of fools, and it wouldn't be good idea for them to stay there. There is no place for us. Let's go, he said to his disciple. But the disciple didn't want to leave the place. Everything was cheap here. All he wanted was good, cheap food. The guru said, they are all fools. This wasn't last very long, and you can't tell what they will do to you next. So in the third paragraph, the guru was a very wise person. He told his disciple that it would not be safe for them to stay in this kingdom, as this kingdom is a kingdom of fools. But the disciple was not ready to leave the place, because everything was cheap and good, and the food is also available in very in a single doodoo. So the disciple became very greedy, and he said that he is not going to leave this place. But the guru left the kingdom, and the disciple stayed on. Being a great foodie, means the disciple, he ate his fill every day and become fat in a few days also. So according to guru, he said that they are all fools. Means this kingdom is full of fools, and they won't be last very long, and you don't know what will happen with you in the next time. So the guru said to his disciple, let's go, we will not stay here, because this place is not safe. This here it is very danger, and this kingdom is full of fools, because the king and the minister are fools, so we should leave. But the disciple became very greedy, and he said that he is not going to leave this place. Next page, fourth paragraph. But the disciple wouldn't listen to guru's wisdom. He wanted to stay. The guru finally gave up and said, do what you want, I am going, and left. The disciple stayed on, ate his fill every day, bananas and ghee and rice and wheat, and grew fat like a street side scared bull. Now what happened? After guru was a wise person, so he already told his disciple that this place is not a safe place. This is a very dangerous place. So we should leave here. But the disciple didn't understand his wording, and he said that he will stay here. So the guru said that he just gave up, and he said that okay, whatever you want to do, you just do it. And he left that the disciple here. Now disciple started eating there bananas, ghee, rice and wheat, and grew fat like a bull. Now the next paragraph. One bright day, a thief broke into a rich merchant's house. He had made a hole in the wall and sneaked in. And as he was carrying out his loot, the wall of the old house collapsed on his head and killed him on the spot. His brother ran to the king and complained, Your Highness, when my brother was pursuing his ancient trade, a wall fell on him and killed him. This merchant is to blame. He should have built a good strong wall. You must punish the wrongdoer and compensate the family for his justice. The next paragraph, the king said, justice will be done, don't worry, and at once summoned the owner of the house. So what happened? One day, a thief broke into a rich merchant's house by making a big hole in the wall. But as he was going out with the stolen things, the wall of the old house collapsed on his head and killed him on the spot. Now see, what the king is doing after listening the brother. Like the brother of the thief came running to the king and pleaded. Means he pleaded in front of him and he said that king just punished the merchant. Why? Because for not building a good and strong wall. And the merchant was brought before the king. Now what happened? When the brother of thief went to the courtyard of king and he said that that the justice should be there, you should punish the merchant because my brother has gone for his ancient there was a word here giving the ancient trade means he was sabka ek work hota hai na, like the person is doing his work jo saalon se chala aa raha hai. So he is saying that my whole family is a thief and they are stealing the things. So he was saying that my brother was doing his ancient trade, and when he was doing his ancient trade, a wall fell on him and he was dead. And what was the ancient trade? That was a stealing the thing. I mean, they stole, like that, you can say robbing the thing. And the merchant is to blame. Now his brother is saying that the merchant should be blamed for this. He should have built a strong and good wall. Now you should punish the wrongdoer and compensate the family. And to whom compensate the family? To the thief family. Now this king is fool. This king is, and the ministers are idiots. So he said that yes, justice should be done. So don't worry. And at once summoned the owner of the house. Means they called the owner of the house. So that is summoned means owner. So he just said that just call the owner of the house. So students, till there I am taking your class. Next I will be taking your class tomorrow, in which I will be taking the next two pages, that is 21 and 22. Till then, take care students, and bye.